mythical myths and legends. There are few more famous than the Flying Dutchman. Many have claimed to have seen the ghostly vessel of Captain Hendrik van der Decken since it disappeared in 1641, after the captain had made the perilous journey from Holland to the East Indies to purchase spices, silks, and dyes. Homeward bound and rounding the Cape of Good Hope, a terrible gale sprang up. The sailors begged their captain to turn around and drop anchor, but he refused, ordering the course held and challenging the wrath of God by uttering a blasphemous oath. Captain van der Decken and his crew were thereafter doomed to sail the high seas for eternity, only allowed to make landfall once every 7 years. The curse would be lifted if the captain could find a woman strong enough and willing to die for him and redeem his soul. We begin our tale near a craggy shore. An ominous fog hugs the coastline, while out at sea a terrifying storm is raging. A Norwegian vessel under the command of Captain Daland is attempting to secure anchorage, sailors noisily pulling in the sails, casting ropes, battening the hatches. Earlier, Captain Daland had gone ashore, but with an easing of the storm, he returns to his ship and retires to his cabin. The steersman is alone on deck, making his rounds when a rogue wave shakes the ship ferociously. He is frightened, but soon ascertains there is no imminent danger. Sitting down, he muses aloud until sleep overtakes him. The skies darken and the storm begins to rage anew. In the distance appears the ship of the Flying Dutchman with blood-red sails and black masts. The ship races towards the shoreline. When coming opposite the Norwegian vessel, it stops suddenly, dropping anchor. The steersman starts, hastily glances towards the helm, murmurs softly to himself, and falls back asleep. The Dutchman's ghostly crew begins the work of anchoring their ship in eerie silence. The Dutchman emerges from his cabin and goes to shore, where he reflects on his fate and impending doom. Captain Daland notices the Dutchman's ship, shakes the steersman awake, and quizzes him about the strange vessel. Daland and the Dutchman then meet and talk. The Dutchman discovers Daland has a daughter, Senta, and cunningly offers Daland the treasures of his ship in exchange for lodging for the night. On the brink of eternal damnation, he wonders whether now he might yet be saved by redeeming love. The Dutchman inquires of a meeting with Senta as a possible bride. Although taken aback and uneasy at the Dutchman's request and mysterious manner, Daland agrees to relinquish his daughter's hand in exchange for the Dutchman's treasures. The two captains then set their sails for Daland's home.
Thank you. Thank you. capitaine. Et voilà, c'est le même des choses.
Leidet keinen Schaden.
Thank you. Shows up.